I'm Nico Steytler. I'm the South African Research Chair in Multilevel Government at the Dullah Omar Institute at University of Western Cape. Yesterday we launched a book that I just edited, The BRICS Partnership, Challenges, Prospects for Multilevel Government. The idea came, the idea for this book came when I realized that the five BRICS countries, Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa, had all multi-level government systems. And the question was then, how would this fact impact on the BRICS initiatives? And it came quite apparent from the start that the BRICS initiative had two legs. The first one was an international trade leg, trying to make ensure that there's a more free and fair trading dispensation globally. But the second leg was to look at domestic issues like health, education, agriculture, the environment, and also urbanization. Now the question then was how that these factors or these domestic agenda are the matters that your subnational governments would deal with, the provinces and states in India, Brazil, South Africa, and also in China, where there's a high level of decentralization taking place with very powerful large cities and provinces. Now the theme of the book is threefold. The first one is to see how the BRICS initiative fits in with the constitutional dispensation in each country. If in fact the BRICS agenda is going to impose and deal with matters that's also in the domain of provinces and states, how will the states first implement such initiatives, and secondly, would they have an independent role with respect to how you shape the BRICS policy at a national level, at an international level. The BRICS initiative has realized that, also recognized this multi-level dimension to their own countries. And so we see the establishment of a friendly cities and local government forum, as well as an urbanization forum, indicating the importance that the BRICS initiative takes with regard to particularly cities and urbanization. There's also a council of regions that has been proposed by Russia, and that is still in the offing, and it may well be established soon. So the second theme of the book is the impact that the BRICS initiative would have on the intergovernmental finances. Of importance here is the fact of the establishment of the new development bank, the first concrete institution of BRICS. And the focus there will be on making loans for infrastructure development, which leads us to the last theme of the book, is urbanization. All five countries are characterized by a high degree of urbanization or in the process of urbanizing. And we think here particularly of China and India, with lesser degree in South Africa. But they all face large agglomerations of cities, and the question is how will the BRICS initiative assist in dealing with urbanization? What becomes clear that there is a learning network between the five already established and the new development bank focusing on infrastructure investment will of course play an important role in providing loans for infrastructure build in urban areas. This interaction between the multi-level government of the member states and the BRICS initiative has so far been an unexplored area, and it was worthy for this examination by scholars from all five countries. So the book has got three chapters from each country by people from the academics from those countries. This book will be of interest for people working in government, both at the subnational government level as well as at the federal national level. Also, it would be of interest for lawyers who have to deal with investment and other trading agreements, as well as academia, who must, in fact, investigate and study this phenomenon. For further information, please look at the website of Judo Law.